Good day, students. Welcome to MathGodServe.com. In this clip, we're going to be going over how to find critical values of a function. All right, so the instructions for the examples as follows. We are to, for number one, find the critical values for the function f of x equals 3x minus 2x to the 2/3. Okay, so before we get started, let's go over what critical values are real quick, all right? So I'd like you to recall the fact that critical values are when the derivative f prime is equal to 0 or the derivative f prime of x does not exist. Okay? So these are the two cases where we have critical values. Now, when the derivative is equal to 0, what we have is a horizontal tangent line. Okay? We have a horizontal tangent line when the derivative is equal to 0. Now that is one of the situations where you have a critical value. Now the second case is when the derivative does not exist. What results in the nonexistence of the derivative? Or basically, when is a function not differentiable? Well, in that case, you have either a vertical tangent line or you have no tangent line at all. Okay? So when do you have critical values? An easy way to remember is when you have hortan, vertan, or notan. Okay? Horizontal tangent for when the derivative is equal to 0. Vertical tangent or no tangent line when the derivative does not exist. All right, so let's keep those points in mind. Now let's take a look at the steps involved in finding the critical values of a function. Number one, you have to first find the derivative of the given function f prime of x. Next, you will then find when the derivative is equal to 0 and when it does not exist. Okay, so find x where we have the following equations: f prime of x equals 0, horizontal tangent line, or f prime of x does not exist. All right, let's go ahead and apply this step to this problem right here. So we have f of x, the original function, equals 3x minus 2x to the 2/3. Now let's go ahead and differentiate using the power rule. F prime of x is going to be the derivative of 3x, which is 3, minus the derivative of 2x to the 2/3 is 2 times 2/3 x raised to the 2/3 minus 1. Okay, let's simplify that. We have 3 minus 4/3 x to the 1 can be written as 3 over 3. So if you subtract 1 or 3 over 3 from 2/3, you'll be left with negative 1/3. Okay, now let's still simplify it a little bit further. We can write this as 3 minus 4 over 3x to the 1/3. Using the reciprocal property of exponents to reciprocate the term with the negative exponent. Now, when we're looking for horizontal tangent, or when the derivative is non-existent, we want to try to express the function as a quotient of two expressions, okay? In this case, we have a function here and an integer here. This is not the best method to help us accurately determine the x values where we have zero tangent or non-existent tangent. So what I'm going to do is I'll proceed to unite these two terms into one. So we'll have one clear numerator and one clear denominator. Okay, so how do we combine these two? I'll express this integer as a fraction. The LCD of 1 and 3x to the 1/3 is 3x to the 1/3. So I'll multiply this by 3x to the 1/3 at the top and the bottom. Okay, and that will give us 9. We multiply the 3's together, so we'll have 9x to the 1/3 over 3x to the 1/3 minus 4 over 3x to the 1/3. Now, can I combine these two fractions? Absolutely, because we have identical denominators. So f prime of x can be written as 9x to the 1/3 minus 4 divided by 3x to the 1/3. Now, writing it in this format is excellent because we have a clear numerator and a clear denominator that can help us find when the derivative is equal to 0 or non-existent. Okay, so let's go ahead and do it. Let's start with where f prime of x is equal to 0. In this case, you just simply extract the numerator of the reduced function. We are going to extract the numerator and set it equal to 0. All right. So we have 9x to the 1/3 minus 4. Set that equal to 0. Well, you might ask, why did we do that? Well, this is the reason. If you set this function equal to 0 and you cross multiply, what happens is that the denominator gets multiplied by 0 and the numerator gets multiplied by 1, so you always be left with the numerator. Okay? So whenever the numerator of a rational function in reduced form is equal to 0, the entire function attains a value of 0, as long as it doesn't impact the denominator value. Okay, so let's see. Solve this for x. To do that, we'll first add 4 to both sides. This is just basic algebra right now. And we have 9x to the 1/3 equals 4. We can now proceed to divide both sides by 9. Divide by 9, divide by 9. And we have x to the 1/3 equals 4 over 9. And then to get x isolated, we will raise both sides of the equation to the 3rd power. That is the inverse of the 3rd root. Okay? On the left side, we have x. On the right side, we just basically raise 4 to the 3rd power over 9 raised to the 3rd power. That will give us our first critical value. 4 to the 3rd is 64. In 9 to the 3rd power is 729. Okay, so that is C1. Now let's go to the second group of critical values. That happens when the derivative does not exist. Now, what causes a rational function to have an undefined output? That happens when the denominator attains a value of 0. So all we are going to do here is extract the denominator of this function and set it equal to 0. That will tell us the x values that will cause the denominator to be 0, which results in the entire function being undefined. Okay, so let's do that. We extract the denominator 3x to the 1/3 and set that equal to 0. Now to get x isolated, we'll divide both sides by 3. Divide by 3, divide by 3. And then you end up with x to the 1/3 equals 0 over 3 is just 0. And then we'll proceed to raise both sides to the 3rd power. That's the inverse of the 3rd root. And you're left with the second critical value, which is equal to 0. Okay? So what's the importance of critical values? Well, critical values are your potential extrema. Alright? All our extrema are critical values, but not all the critical values are extrema. So this is just one step towards finding the extrema. You determine your critical values. And in order to determine if these are in fact extrema, you either have to look at the graph. You could use the second derivative test or the first derivative test on these two critical values, and you can determine if they are in fact extremas or not. Okay, so remember, these are potential extremas. You have to subject them to further tests in order to determine if they are an extrema, either a maximum or a minimum. Okay, so this is basically how you find critical values of functions. Thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. I really appreciate it. If you found the contents of this tutorial helpful in your study of the extremal functions and critical values, do give us a thumbs up. Your positive feedback is very important to us. If you have any questions or comments on what we covered in this presentation, or any calculus questions in general, just place your questions in the comment section below, and we'll be more than glad to support you. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for updates to other AP Calc tutorials such as this. More clips can be found on math.serve.com under AP Calculus. Thanks again for watching, and have a wonderful day. Goodbye.